A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 25th October. On the front page you have BJP Sena win in Maharashtra, hung house in Haryana. So Congress has put up a robust show in northern state, that is in Haryana, even as debutant Jan Nayak Janata Party emerged as a regional force to reckon with. So here you can see it has won 10 seats in Haryana. So this is the election result. Then here you have India-Pakistan signed Kartarpur Pact. So this is a pact which will facilitate Indian pilgrims to visit Gurudwara Kartarpur Sahib in Pakistan. And this is Supreme Court tells telecom companies to pay government 92,000 crores. So this is a big blow to telecom service providers. Supreme Court has upheld Department of Telecom's move to recover adjusted gross revenue of about 92,000 crore from telecom companies. So just yesterday we saw government has deferred payment for the spectrum which has been awarded to various telecom companies, that they can pay, make that payment after 2 years. But now the Supreme Court ruling has said that Department of Telecom's move to recover adjusted gross revenue is upheld, and telecom companies have to pay that. So here you can see the status quo. Telecom sector long reaped the fruits of center's liberalized mode of payment by the revenue sharing regime. So it has benefited immensely under the scheme, as apparent from the gross revenue trend from 2004 to 2015. But now service providers have failed to fulfill the obligations to the government and have raised frivolous objections. So this is what the Supreme Court observed. A bench led by Justice Arun Mishra. Here you can see. So here you can see adjusted gross revenue has to be paid by them. So Supreme Court dismissed telecom service providers' objection to the government's formulation of adjusted gross revenue. Judgment said gross revenue shall be inclusive of installation charges, late fee, sale proceeds of handsets, revenue on account of interest, dividends, so entire gross revenue. On that, telecom companies will have to pay to the government. So this is what the court said, that government intended to pump revenue from its share of telecom gross revenue into developing remote and uncovered areas. So this was already done under USOF, Universal Service Obligation Fund, which is a committed liability. So telecom companies make contribution there too, which is providing optical fiber cables to gram panchayats under USOF program. It's also called Digital India Mission. So this is there. Then here you have construction activities banned from October 26 to 30 in Delhi NCR. So steps have been taken by Delhi government to ensure that pollution remains under control. This winter season, green crackers are being made mandatory. They are available in the city stores, unlike last year now. And also task force has been established, which has issued directions to shut coal based industries also. On page 8 you have AP likely had a flourishing port 2000 years ago. So Archaeological Survey of India hopes to find more evidence in the second round when it conducts excavations here. So Maritime Trade Center, based out of a fortified settlement near the banks of the Suvarnamukhi River in Andhra Pradesh. It may have had a trade guild with its own army to protect its interests, is what is being suggested, which may have been in around 2000 years ago. So the excavation of this site is going on. So brick built structures in elliptical, circular and rectangular shapes have been excavated. Also here you can see this is a four-armed, 2-meter tall sculpture of Vishnu, which has been unearthed at this site. So it dates back to Pallava period. Looking at the features like the headgear and the drapery. Then on page 9 you have, a judge cannot be suspected of bias. So this is what Justice Arun Mishra said while pronouncing a verdict on pleas seeking his recusal. So this case has been further stretched. He refuses to step down. We have already discussed about Mr. Arun Mishra, Justice Arun Mishra, the case in which he is going to rule on his own ruling, whether the ruling was correct or not. On the editorial page, the first editorial is Tamed Victors. So this is regarding assembly elections in Maharashtra and Haryana. So BJP has found out now that hyper-nationalism has its limit in assembly elections. So BJP, Shiv Sena retained power in Punjab, but retained power in Maharashtra, but in Haryana, BJP emerged as the single largest party, but it is short of majority. And second editorial is good report card. So this is regarding how the states must be doing their bit to improve the ease of doing business in India. So World Bank's Ease of Doing Business 2020 survey has seen India figure in the top 10 most improved countries in the world for the third consecutive year. So India has been ranked ranked 63 in 2020, starting from 142 in 2014. Then the lead article is two elections and a dent to jingoistic edifice. So BJP's pursuit of hyper-nationalist approach in Maharashtra and Haryana did not fetch it complete dividends. And below you have again regarding elections, the poll win direction may have changed. Despite BJP's advantages in Maharashtra and Haryana, emphasis on issues of nationalism as such, local issues actually counted. Then on OPED page on Fridays, you have this parley coverage in which a question is raised and discussion takes place on this issue. So this is, should schools have prayers? So it says that the constitution says that institutions getting state funding cannot provide religious instructions. So do prayers in the morning assembly amount to giving religious instructions is a question being raised. Then here you have Putin takes center stage in Syria. So we have seen how Turkey has also had a deal with Russia, and Russia has now come at the center stage in Syria after US opted out. On page 12, you have give clear-cut picture on curbs, Supreme Court tells Jammu and Kashmir. So Supreme Court has reminded government that restrictions have already been in place for 2 months, and a clear-cut picture should come from the authorities on how long they planned to continue with restrictions in Jammu and Kashmir. On international page, you have 39 found dead in UK truck were Chinese. Chinese embassy says that it is in contact with Essex police to seek clarification and confirmation. So this was the front page news yesterday. How 39 bodies were recovered from a truck. It was feared that it was trafficking in which these people were involved and were victims. And this is Kurdish forces start pullback from Syria, Turkey. So now again, it's the same issue, Syria, Turkey issue. Kurdish forces in the northeastern Syria have left several positions along the extensive border. And this is Zuckerberg open to scaling back Facebook's digital coin plan. So you should know about Libra, the digital coin, which had been announced by Facebook. So it has said that it may scale down plans for this digital coin if it cannot win approval of the approval as a new currency for global exchanges. On business page, you have India climbs 14 notches in ease of doing business ranking. So from 77th rank in 2019, now it is on 63 rank in 2019. So this is World Bank's ease of doing business report, which has been published. So it's actually 2020 study. So the ranking as such has been announced in 2020 when India is at 63 position. And this is what the editorial today is also about. And below you have US agency begins probe into planes against Infosys. So the US Security and Exchange Commission, and which is an independent agency of US federal government, has begun its investigation into whistleblower complaints against top brass of tech major Infosys. And this is again regarding the front page news on Supreme Court order for telecom sectors. So it is said final straw for already distressed telecom sector. So Supreme Court order will affect fundraising capacity of telecom companies. Then on the last page you have 2 out of 3 wild polioviruses strains have been eradicated. So this is what the World Health Organization says. Efforts have been taken to eliminate the one type which is still there in 2 countries, Afghanistan and Pakistan. So type 3. So you can see it has announced that wild poliovirus type 3 has been eradicated worldwide. So eradication of smallpox and wild poliovirus type 2 has already been achieved. And now type 3 has also been eradicated. But still type 1 is a concern. So that will also be eradicated soon is the expectation. It remains in just 2 countries, Afghanistan and Pakistan. So that is it. These are the important headlines. Thank you.